Hello, this is Harry Norman for Proactive Investors, and welcome to another Proactive Audio interview. Today is the 8th of September 2009, and I'm talking with Harry Anagnostaras-Adams, Managing Director of EMED Mining, listed on the AIM market mining sector. Stock ticker EMED, share price 13.75 pence, market cap 43.06 million pounds sterling, web address emed-mining.com. Harry, thank you very much for joining us while you're standing on the top of your gold discovery at Bielý Vrich in Slovakia.
Yes, a lovely day and right here on top of our gold deposit.
When EMED Mining was founded, its focus was on Europe's untapped geological potential. What is EMED Mining's current focus, Harry?
That hasn't changed in the 4.5 years since the company was admitted onto the AIM board of the London Stock Exchange. We've established projects in a number of countries in Europe, and the two most important projects that we're focusing on predominantly are just under 1 million tonnes of JORC resource copper in Spain at Rio Tinto, and just over 1 million ounces of JORC resource gold at Bielý Vrich here in Slovakia. So one was an acquisition, Rio Tinto we bought, and one was a discovery. Here in Slovakia, we discovered basically doing exactly what we said, and that's our continuing focus.
When we last spoke, you just bought the Rio Tinto copper mine outright. Could you bring us up to speed with progress at the Rio Tinto copper mine restart in Spain?
It's been both exciting in some respects and disappointing in others. Exciting in that everything we've learned as we've worked through the due diligence technically has reinforced our original conclusion. We've improved a little bit on that as we've gone through, in that we'll need to spend less money than we originally thought, and we'll achieve some operational milestones quicker and bigger than we originally thought once we get going. The disappointment has been that the process of permitting has been slower than originally thought, so that's been a frustration. It's been exacerbated partly by the global financial crisis slowing us down and slowing the world down. That sort of took the wind out of our sails for about 6 months, I suppose. And also there's been some obstruction by some parties who used to be involved with it, who we've had to remove, who've been making a nuisance of themselves, and that slowed us down a bit. But it's definitely on track, and we're working very well with the regulatory authorities now. So although we've lost some time, I'm more confident than I've ever been that we'll be going ahead.
What remains to be done before EMED can recommission the Rio Tinto copper mine, Harry?
There's two steps, really. One is special permitting in a formal sense that starts this month, hopefully, and it completes 6 months later, unless there's any deficiencies in our applications, which we're not aware of any at this stage. So stage one is really the completion of formal permitting, and we see that as being completed in the first quarter of 2010 in accordance with the formal timetables that we've been discussing with the authorities. And the second stage is the actual physical activities at the site, which themselves take approximately 6 months. But we obviously can't start them until we've totally and completely finished the permitting to ensure that it's a full green light in every respect. So we expect to trigger the restart in terms of the physical activities and recruitment of the workforce in Q2 of 2010, and then be commissioning production at the end of 2010.
How confident are you of the project economics of the Rio Tinto mine, Harry?
Well, it's really a twofold question. One is, what are the costs of the operation? We're very confident of it because it's a pre-existing site, and we've been able to access historical statistics and production records to audit, if you like, what the outputs should be and what the inputs for production are. And we've gone around it, audited those costs, so we're very confident of the cost forecasts based on historical verification. The other side of the question is the copper price. In our own view, the copper price will be sustainable in the longer term at above $2 a pound. Today it's more like $3 a pound, and all our numbers, our base case numbers, are based on $2 a pound, and they're entirely profitable at that level. Obviously, if it's still $3 a pound when we start up, then we'll make more money than we're sort of counting on. And we'll have to install the hedging of the copper price for the first little while to protect the project whilst it gets up onto its feet in full production sense. So that's a much safer project than most because of its historical record and because it made the copper price that we're enjoying today in the marketplace.
You have a JORC-compliant resource estimate of 1.1 million ounces of gold at Bielý Vrich on your Detva prospect in Slovakia. What are your plans for Bielý Vrich?
We're in the throes of completing a scoping study with our project consultants, ANC. That scoping study is nearing completion now. There's, from what I'm seeing, there's nothing in it which is inconsistent with what we've foreshadowed in the past from our own figurings and releases to shareholders, and that is that an open cut on that JORC resource appears both economic and warranted, and therefore I think it's highly likely that when we polish off the scoping study and release it to shareholders, everyone will see, if you like, in detail why that preliminary conclusion of ours remains intact, and therefore I think we'll be looking at a development here after completion of the full feasibility study. So I'd say that after Spain's up and running, we'll move on to the development in Slovakia. That's really the base case, and that continues to be the base case.
What are your hopes and plans for your other prospects in Slovakia, Harry?
Well, we have a large number of other prospects here, many of them similar in style to Bielivik, but none of them at this stage is advanced enough to get to confident about. We are confident about the fact that we've got an economic deposit of Bielivik, and we're confident about the fact that we own a large gold district which hasn't been worked over properly in modern times the way we've started to. So I think it's highly likely we'll come up with another economic deposit in Slovakia, but at this stage it's what I call fairly early stage prospecting.
Do you expect the price of gold to remain strong, Harry?
I think there's two answers to that. First, I think it'll revert to the average of the industry cost position or a bit above that. Average industry costs today, operating costs, are in the order of $500 an ounce. And at worst, when it has its down bumps in its cycle, the gold price will go down towards 700-ish or something like that, I feel. But, you know, every metal, as with most commodities, have their cycles. But the underlying direction for gold is actually to be one where it should be escalating price. And I think that's purely a function of China and India industrializing and 2 billion people who live there buying more gold as an investment. And I think that's going to underpin the gold price for a long time to come. So I'd be surprised if the gold price wasn't $1,000 plus for the next 5 years.
What is EMED Mining's financial situation, Harry?
We have some cash in the bank. We have some undrawn facilities to draw down equity capital as and when required. And our plan is to basically keep the place tight and the cash burn rate as small as possible until we trigger the restart at Rio Tinto early next year. And at that point, we would then draw down the planned project finance facilities to fund the restart at $3. If we're fortunate enough for the copper price to stay up where it is now, the payback on that project finance would be very rapid. So it should be a fairly straightforward financing.
What can we expect from EMED Mining over the next 12 to 18 months, Harry?
A series of milestones as we work through getting the various steps of permitting in Rio Tinto complete and announced as the government clears each little hurdle for us. The commencement of the preparations at site. We've done a lot in the past, but because of the global financial crisis earlier in the year, we suspended site activities other than care and maintenance. But we'd reactivate all that as permitting starts to flow, and it'll start sort of revving up and commissioning at the end of next year. So the company would be moving from a development planner to a development implementer and production starting up the end of 2010. At the same time in Slovakia, we would be about halfway through our permitting and planning cycle on that project. Every project has its own gestation period, albeit that I and everyone else involved with the company, including shareholders, would like things to go quicker. It's also true that from forming a company 4.5 years ago, be in production on a 1 million tonne copper mine and to be in development on a 1 million ounce gold mine would be rapid fire timetable compared to 99 out of 100 mining companies in the world, where the gestation period on these projects is a lot longer. So I don't know if people in London quite appreciate that sometimes, but from people from the mining industry don't expect production on new projects to start up within 5 years typically, but we'll have done that, I think, and we'll be in production in Slovakia within 2 years of that as well.
Remember, Proactive Investors is not an investment advice service. Make sure you register at proactiveinvestors.co.uk for our weekly newsletter, which will keep you informed about our articles, interviews, and events. Thank you for listening.